Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. Today we're gonna look at how to embed a Pinterest board into your WordPress website. Here's the cool thing, you guys. No plugin required and a totally free budget. There is, though, a little bit of a need to have a child theme in place. Don't let that stress you out, though, because I'm gonna give you a plugin to fix that problem. This is gonna take us no more than 5 minutes. Check this out. Here we go. So last week, you know, I talked about how to do a really cool Instagram feed, but I wanna go this week and go grab that Pinterest board. So you wanna log into your Pinterest account, you wanna go to the board that you would like to embed in your WordPress website, and when you're viewing that board, you should see these three dots. You're gonna click on those and click Make a Widget. If I go too quickly, just pause this video. It's all right, we're gonna move pretty fast though. Automatically, it takes you to the spot that it already pulled in the exact board that you want. If you like the look of this, you're off and running. If you want to make some customizations, you can do that as well. So that's really cool. For the sake of this tutorial, we're going to take this exact example and go plug it into our website. So this is the nerd code, and this is all you need. We're going to copy that on our clipboard and head over to our widgets area, because I'd really like to have this kind of in my sidebar area over here. I think it'd look really nice. So jumping into your widgets area, you can go into that area and you've got like a, just wanna be sure you're in the right sidebar, right? Whatever area is in that sidebar. So this is the one that has the image and the text, and so this is this correct sidebar. We're gonna go in here and just grab a regular old text. Widget box is fine, and I wanna put it right underneath that image. I'm gonna go into the text mode here and I'm gonna paste in the nerd code. That's all you need, click save. Now it's not gonna render just yet. If I click refresh over here, it's gonna just show dead space for right now because we're missing this second little nerd code. And this is what requires to be plugged in inside of your child theme. And so I've already done a video, by the way, on how to make a child theme with a plugin. Super crazy simple. I'll put the link to that video in the description box below. It might be a little older tutorial, but it still works. And it's using the exact same plugin I'm using today called Child Theme Configurator. So over in my plugins area, I've already installed Child Theme Configurator. And because that's in here, I'm able to go into my tools section now, go over to Child Themes, and actually be sure that I have a footer PHP file available inside of my child theme. So they're gonna duplicate this file for me and put it inside my child theme. Now that they've done that, when I go over here to Appearance and go to Editor, now I have a footer file right here inside of my child theme that I can use. And I want to put this in. If you read here, it tells you right before the in body tag, they want you to paste it in. So we're going to come right down here to the in body area. I'm going to paste in that nerd code and type in update file. We're going to go back over to our website, click refresh, and our feed should pop right in there. How cool is that, you guys? If you love this and you have any questions about it, be sure to comment in the description box below and in the thread. I want to help you, and I'll see you next WordPress Wednesday. Bye, y'all.